Let's talk about trust, specifically trustworthy AI. It's a pretty important topic these days. Welcome back to the AI Generation, a series where we dive into all things Gen AI. I'm Dominique Weatherspoon, and if you're anything like me, you're a little wary about this AI revolution that's happening right now. AI is everywhere, whether we know it or not, and it affects all of us, so trusting it is important. Several years ago, a large tech company built an AI model to screen resumes and select candidates. They discovered that the tool was biased against female candidates because the tool was trained from previous resumes, which were disproportionately from male candidates. So, the tool started prioritizing certain keywords and other information that was male-specific. And that's just one example. So we're gonna learn more and find out what we can do to make sure untrustworthy AI is a thing in the past. Let's dive in. As AI continues to grow, it'll affect nearly every aspect of our lives, from professional to personal, in some really amazing ways. But it also poses significant risks if it's created without intentionality and discipline. These risks are making us anxious. Seriously, therapists are seeing an influx of clients with AI anxiety. Those of us paying attention can't help but worry about what AI is going to mean for us in our careers and lives and for our privacy. We're all affected by AI, and we have to get it right. You could define trustworthy AI in many ways, but the way we like to think of it is developing and using AI technologies in an ethical manner, ensuring it doesn't harm people, asking not just could we, but should we, and building AI in a way that reflects our values as a society. A recent global survey showed that nearly all business leaders who responded are excited about the technology and are planning to invest in it. But their main concerns came back to this need for trustworthy AI. Look at these answers. Data privacy and security top the list, driving home how important it is to protect the use and application of an individual's data. And governance is also on their minds. We'll talk more about that in a bit, but it's incredibly important to have a governance process in place to establish standards of trustworthy AI, especially as laws and regulations become more widespread. So yeah, this is a big deal. Data ethics expert Christy Boyd is joining us now to talk more about the importance of making sure we all embrace trustworthy AI now.
Thanks, Dominique. So why is embracing trustworthy AI important? Well, first and foremost, we have a moral imperative to do good. AI is a powerful tool, and we all know the phrase that with great power comes great responsibility. This could not be more true when we're talking about AI. Also, consumers are smart. We're becoming more and more aware of our privacy rights and the threats that AI could pose to those rights. Organizations that are transparent, have a strong ethical code, and a proven track record of doing what's right are going to come out on top in this new landscape. And from a legal perspective, businesses are going to have to get on board now because more and more laws and regulations are being passed. For example, the EU AI Act ensures the safe and ethical use of AI developed, deployed, or used in the European Union, but it also has implications beyond the EU. Similar regulations are starting to take hold in the US and around the world. These laws are great news for consumers and really help underscore the importance of trustworthy AI, but organizations have to be proactive to stay compliant.
Thanks, Christy. That makes it pretty clear that the time to act is now. Let's talk about how organizations can do just that. Large language models, LLMs. You know them. You might even love them if you're a frequent user of ChatGPT or Gemini. LLMs can go seriously sideways without governance, though, creating all kinds of ethical dilemmas. Not to mention, it takes a lot of work to get a model trained, tested, and into production. So if a model is biased or creates harm, like that tech company example we talked about earlier, you have to start over, meaning that the exciting and innovative project you want to work on gets put on hold, and your reputation could be damaged. So governance is imperative. This is how data and AI teams make sure results are accurate, explainable, and fair. To do this right, it does take some work, but it's worth it. LLMs are just one piece of the puzzle when it comes to governance, of course. Organizations need a comprehensive strategy that helps establish oversight, ensure compliance with regulations, and develop consistent operations and infrastructure. When we talk about governance, there are three main buckets: data governance, the strategic framework for managing data in an organization; model governance, which guides the entire life cycle of a model; and AI governance, which provides a holistic view of AI usage. These three work together to ensure responsible and effective AI. If you want to dive deeper into governance, we have a ton of resources linked in the description. And of course, as AI is advancing, so is the tech that can help organizations and data scientists navigate the data and AI lifecycle in a safe and ethical way. A really helpful tool teams could look out for is an out-of-the-box trustworthy AI workflow. A workflow like this would automatically assign tasks to help assess data privacy and bias, check model performance, and more. Model cards are another example of helpful tech. They're essentially nutrition labels for AI models. They can highlight accuracy, fairness, and model drift, plus include governance details and other helpful information. With the right tools in place, we can more easily work towards our trustworthy AI goals. Who's doing it right and what results are they seeing? We're going to talk with someone who has some experience with AI governance. Could you introduce yourself and tell us how you work with trustworthy AI?
Yes, of course. Thank you for having me, Dominique. So my name is Frank van Praat. I am part of KPMG in the Netherlands. I'm a partner leading the responsible AI team. So we are specialized in advising organizations on how to implement trustworthy AI, both for specific AI solutions as well as on the enterprise-wide level.
When you're working with a client using generative AI, what AI governance problems are you experiencing and addressing?
So I see actually two major ones. I see more, but I think these are the most critical ones. So the first being, having the right data, but also from a privacy and security perspective. So we all know that those generative AI systems use our data to improve, for example, and also to answer questions. They are pre-trained on the large data sets in the outside world, so to say, but to actually get to the right value, you also need to incorporate your own data. And I see organizations struggling with getting the right data of the right quality to actually make that work in practice. And that also brings me to the second challenge there is, where are those valuable use cases actually lying in the organization? So mostly it's about gaining a bit more efficiency, doing things a bit better, but it's also about how can we really improve or increase our revenue in certain ways, and actually identifying those valuable use cases. I think that's also a big challenge for organizations, especially if they also need to incorporate our own data, which is typically not of the right quality yet to bring those models to the right quality overall.
Why is trustworthy AI important to you, your organization, and your clients?
Yeah, trustworthy AI personally for me is important because what I see happening is that more and more organizations are using AI systems, and therefore the impact is increasing, especially also, for example, if governmental organizations are using AI. And I think as a citizen or as a consumer, I need to be protected that those AI systems are actually trustworthy, explainable, and are doing the right thing. So from that perspective, I feel personally connected to the topic. From an organizational perspective or client perspective, which for me is pretty much similar, I think it's the next step to actually scaling your AI ambitions within the organization. So it's making sure that everything that you do is actually trustworthy, that you're able to explain how you are implementing your models and that you are really understanding how they work. That will bring you actually the next steps in your AI journey, because then the trustworthiness in your organization will lead to more and more value, and that's where you eventually want to go towards.
Thanks, Frank. So we've covered the what, why, and how of trustworthy AI. Find deeper dives into all of this in the description. And make sure you subscribe below so you don't miss our other episodes. Have AI or Gen AI questions? Add them in the chat. We'll see you next time on the AI Generation.